very warm welcome to Daily Dispatch, a show that gives you all the latest news and updates from the world of startups. I'm Priya Sheth. It's 5 PM. Thank you so much for logging in for this very special show. But first, let's look at the top headlines that we've been tracking this evening. The first space that has been in focus is the EdTech space that has been seeing a multitude of deals that have been taking place over the last few days. In fact, online learning startup Unacademy has raised as much as $50 million from existing investors. Do remember that in November 2020, Unacademy raised some funds from investors like Dragoneer Investments as well as Tiger Global. Unacademy claims to have about 3.5 lakh paying subscribers at present. Well, moving on to the second headline of the day, online logistics company Delhivery has cut losses by as much as 1,500 crore rupees in FY20. This comes as the company prepares to go public over the next 12 to 18 months. Delhivery is also looking at expanding its team from 350 currently to 500 over the next couple of months. Well, millions of users seem to be migrating to the Signal app amid WhatsApp's privacy concerns. In fact, founder Brian Acton said that Signal's straightforward and simple privacy policy is what is wooing Indian consumers to really download the app. Interestingly, Signal saw more than 2 million downloads in India last week. Well, moving on to the final headline of the day, transport tech app Chalo has raised as much as $7 million from existing investors. With this round of funding, Chalo has raised a total of $30 million so far, and Chalo plans to utilize these funds to expand its existing network. Well, moving on, we have with us a very special guest, somebody who has grown the company, WinGreens, from just a dips and sauces manufacturer to something that is much wider in terms of its overall categories that it's available in. I have with me Anju Srivastava. Thank you very much for joining us today on Your Story TV. Over the last 9 months, we've been seeing the kind of diversification and the number of products that WinGreens has been adding to shelves. Take us through the journey in terms of growth, in terms of how really you've diversified over the last 9 months.
Priya, when the lockdown happened and COVID hit, we realized that all the on-the-ground channels, all the offline channels had virtually shut, and we went online. And e-commerce became a very big thing suddenly. And we realized that one thing, when people come on to a website, they want more products than what you have. I mean, we had a few products, and we realized that people were looking for a lot more things. So we went crazy trying to increase our number of categories, number of SKUs, and give people whatever we felt was in demand, particularly things to do with convenience of cooking, and not they should, just because there is a lockdown and just because there is COVID, they should not lose out on good food. And that was important for us. So we went on this spree of launching many, many new SKUs, many of which we had already R&D'd and kept ready. So it was just a matter of actually packaging them and putting them out there.
So what's the total number of SKUs that you have in the market now?
So now we have over 250 SKUs, but our aim is to get to between 500 and 750 SKUs this year. So, it's just the starting point for us.
So basically, you're looking at tripling the number of SKUs that you have at present. And when you're looking at tripling it, is it categories that you're looking at diversifying into, or is it, are you looking at more for horizontal diversification?
Categories as well as horizontal diversification. So definitely one thing that I can reveal on your channel is that we are going to be a food and beverage company very soon, not just a food company. And we are going to be launching beverages as early as next month, maybe even earlier. And we're expecting that our beverage portfolio will also be as successful, and the business will be as big as our food business. We're looking at diversifying into many other new categories, like preserves, like cheese, anything that has a farm base to it, and anything that really helps, convenience of cooking. We're also looking at broad basing many more, easy to cook with sauces, gravies, international, Indian, across the board for all segments of society, from the masses to the mass premium to the absolutely gourmet and niche also. So what we really want to offer is, easier to work with, healthier and tastier cuisine.
So when you talk about revenues, the figure that I read online was about 100 crore rupees in terms of revenue. What is the updated figure in terms of revenue, and what kind of aspirations as far as revenues are concerned is that you're looking at?
Priya, because some of our channels kind of shut down in between, like the Horeca channel shut down, and we sort of had a slower growth in some of the larger chains because they also had problems due to COVID. Our overall growth, we're looking at around 40 to 50% this year, but the next year we're looking at almost 200 to 50% growth. And that is starting now, has already.
In terms of absolute numbers, how much in terms of revenues does this translate into?
So next year we're looking at a revenue of upwards of 300 crores. So that is the kind of, and this we are going to do through, of course, growing our own range, which our core range organically. At the same time, expanding on all our new products and putting them into various channels. And then we will be doing a lot of inorganic growth. So we will also be acquiring companies, and we will look at larger growth in that way also. We will also be capitalizing on the revival of the general trade sector. We will also be creating our own, we hope to it to be a massive foray into e-commerce. And when you go into e-commerce, you need a lot of very quick, many, many innovations, and also really build that platform for ourselves as our own channel.
When you talk about the kind of growth that you're looking at, of course, that kind of growth requires investment into manufacturing units, investment into overall capex. So, in terms of funding, I wanted to understand, I believe into November 2019 was when you raised 125 crore rupees in terms of funding from Sequoia and other investors. What is the plan in terms of funding? Are you still talking to investors to raise some fresh funds at this point?
Yeah, so we are talking to investors. We're also going to do some debt. And in terms of actually the manufacturing capex and all, ours is a very lean manufacturing. We have a very different model. It's very, very low capex and it's very agile. So we can launch a lot of products very quickly. We also do a lot of, we started doing a lot of third party now. So that doesn't involve our own capex. So, actually the growth, the funding we require is more for the marketing and the growth of the channels that we plan to populate rather than just the capex of it.
Just a final question on the funding bit. What is the kind of funds that you're looking at? Is there a ballpark in terms of how much you're looking at raising, and how soon will you be looking at raising this money?
So we are already speaking to some investors, and we would be raising a sizable number, more than we have raised in the past, but it'll be a combination of debt and equity.
So we are expecting Sequoia to be part of the fundraise then as well.
We don't know, we hope so. But yeah, there is going to definitely be a fundraise, which is already, on the anvil.
All right. Thank you so much for joining us. And we're really hoping to see you raise your largest ever fundraise so far, and an expansion that can help take you places. Thank you so much for joining us today on Your Story TV. It's always a pleasure speaking with you. Thank you so much.
Such a pleasure speaking with you, Priya. Thank you so much for having us here.
Well, with that, it's a wrap on a very special show, Daily Dispatch. Thank you for logging in. I'll see you tomorrow at 5 p.m. with all the movers and shakers of the startup industry. Goodbye, and see you tomorrow.